नहीं नहीं कटेगा भाई, ऐसे कैसे कटेगा?
मैं तो कट जाएगा तो काम कैसे होगा?
गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, सो आई एम डॉक्टर रजत जैन, योर रेडियोलॉजी फैकल्टी, एंड विद मी टुडे आई हैव डॉक्टर सुशील विजय हु इज एन ऑर्थोपेडिक फैकल्टी एंड डॉक्टर सुशांत सोनी हु इज अ पैथोलॉजी फैकल्टी. सो थ्री ऑफ अस विल टेक यू थ्रू योर क्वेरीज अबाउट दी काउंसलिंग एंड लाइक विच सीट्स यू शुड फिल एंड वट इज द प्रोसीजर. You can send your queries to the DRP and as well as on the WhatsApp number that has been shared with all of you by Dr. Bhatia. We will start with procedure of counseling, which will be explained to you in detail by Dr. Sushil Vijay. Then we will going to the other documents required, surrendering seat options, the other number of seats which are available, and then we'll go to the individual subject, what are the opportunities that are available in an individual subject, and then we're going to move to individual queries. Okay, so that is how the session has been planned. So without wasting much time, we will start with the procedure of counseling, which will be explained in detail by Dr. Sushil Vijay.
Okay, so hello guys, I'll just try to explain you the process of counseling, how we started that. Most of the students, they don't know even how to start, where to see, and which website we have to look, right? So the website that you have to look after the notification, obviously that will be out, this website, you can note it down. The website is mcc.nic.in, right? This is the website that you have to log in. This website will allow you to register yourself and then proceed with the rest of the things that you need for counseling. Okay, so how does basically it happens and how you have to enroll yourself? You have to open this website mcc.nic.in and then you have to register yourself. So number one is to register yourself. While registering, what important things you have to keep in mind? Registration here. While registering, all the documents that you have given or that you have produced during the form filling, the All India form, when you are filling that, so all documents that were required during your NEET counseling or NEET form filling, not the counseling, NEET form. So number one is this, and number two, anything other, like other certificate, like your caste certificate or whatever extra certificates you want to produce, the physical handicap certificate, these certificates should be handy with you. So these are two things that you need to have with you while registering yourself. Once you have registered yourself, then you will be moving on to the second page. In that second page, you will be asked to fill the choice of college, right? So in the second number page, you will have the option of filling the choice of college and then the choice of the subject or the course you want to enroll in, right? Now, important thing that you have to remember while filling these two things is that don't think that I just want radiology, so you just fill 10 radiology seats only. You have to fill every seat whichsoever is available. Now, when you fill the seat number one, that should be on the topmost priority. So how you have to fill the topmost priority number one, and then you move down with the least priority that you don't want the seat. But always try to fill the maximum numbers of seats that are possible. Don't just say 10 seats or 20 seats. Number two that you have to think here, that always when you have selected the seats, always see, is it in correct order? You always have an option to shuffle it, always. Last option, last thing that you have to do after choosing your college and the course is to lock it down. Until unless you lock it down, these seats can be shuffled by you many number of times till the date which is given in the format. So MCC will always give you the dates in advance, till which date you can fill the form, till which date you can fill the choice of college and the course, and then register yourself. So once you lock it down, then these courses, the choice, these cannot be changed at all. Okay, so always before locking your choices, make it sure that you have filled all the available options which are available with you. Now this option that you have filled over here, this will be considered for your round one, right? So there is a confusion in different students that how many rounds will be there. So as per the last judgment of Supreme Court that we have, there should be only two rounds this time also. Last year also there were only two rounds, and this year also there will be two rounds only, round one and round two, after which the seats will be shifted to the state quota. Okay, so this will be considered for your round one, and the result of the round one, whatever seat has been allotted to you, will be on the website, will be displayed on the website in the due course of time, the date or the schedule which has been given by MCC. So this is about round one. Now, whichever college has been allotted to you in round one, you have to join it. You cannot say that I don't want this seat and I'll appear for the second round. Do remember that for being available or for being eligible for the round two, there are only three categories of student. So it is must to join the course. It is must. You have to join the course here. It is must to join whatever course has been allotted. Right? So this is about round one.
Very nicely explained, Dr. Sushil. I'll just highlight one point here, like what he is saying about the choice of college and choice of course, friends. Over a period of time, we have seen it, like because most of the time students look at the previous year counselings and they try to identify that. We will also be discussing with you. So let's take a small example. Let's say a student has got rank 100 and now he knows that at rank 100, he was allotted a seat at like he wants surgery at Maulana Azad Medical College, and he know that at rank 100 surgery at Maulana Azad Medical College was available, and he wanted to do just the general surgery. So sometime, what due to some ignorance, what some students do is they just fail MS General Surgery Maulana Azad Medical College, thinking that this will be available. But what happens is that there are 100 students ahead you. There are, let's say, there are 10 seats in of general surgery in Maulana Azad Medical College, and unfortunately those 10 seats have been picked up earlier, and then in nutshell you will not be allotted any seat. So please don't do that. Even if Maulana Azad Medical College surgery is your first option, I will suggest students to have a backup and fill more choices. There is no harm. There is no limit onto the number of choices that you can fill. So our suggestion to the students is, try to fill as many choices as you can. Okay, if you can fill 2000 choices, there is no harm. Fill 2000 choices. Sometimes what happens, student has got 500 rank. He wants to do orthopedics at Maulana Azad Medical College. He feels that the orthopedic will not be available at Maulana Azad Medical College, and that is why he doesn't fill up this choice. And many a time, in exceptional circumstances, that seat might be available. So whatever is your first preference, be it whatever seat, your rank is 4000, your rank is 5000, and you know that one particular seat will not be available at this particular time, there is no harm in putting that at the first list. You never know, everybody else is thinking in the same manner. So make sure that whenever you are filling your choices, do a good brainstorming, make your preference list as the most preferred seat. Even if you have got one rank one, what you would have been the most preferred seat. If you have got 6000, what will be your preferred seat? So start with one and go up to the branch or the seat, whichever will be available. We have seen students who have got good rank and they have got a seat which is not slightly less preferred in comparison to the one who was slightly lower in the rank list, just because of this small mistake. So please do that. Yes,
friends, I'll just like to add one point here. This actually is the most crucial step. Which seat you are going to put up as the preference list? All counselings are unpredictable. Whatever happened last year may not be repeated this year, firstly. Secondly, nobody can guess what your previous rankers are going to take. So have faith on yourself, firstly, and play very safe while choosing the college and the course. This actually is the most important step, which will decide what you are going to do for the next 30 years. So, and write down these choices on a piece of paper before filling it. Don't just sit on the computer and start entering. Write it, do your homework properly, write it on a piece of paper and then fill. This is the most crucial step.
And the second point is what, again, Dr. Sushil has already emphasized, is about that you will be given time to fill your choices, but till the time you have not logged your choices, they will not be taken as final. Once you have logged your choices, then you cannot change it. Okay, one. Second point is that before locking, as he rightly told, that you can change it any number of time. You can do all those permutations and combinations, and you can shuffle one at the top, one at the bottom. Once it has been logged, then it is final. One question that we were getting, Dr. Sushil, on this is that what if you forget to lock?
Yeah, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
So round one, what we have talked about is, in round one you have to choose the college and you have to opt it. Now let's say you filled the college and the course of your choice, but you have forgot to lock it. if you forget to lock it, what will happen is when the last date of locking the choices down will finish, the time is actually it is 5 p.m. of some date, then it will be automatically locked down, right? So in round one, your seat will automatically be allotted to you only if you have filled your choices. It is not about locking or not locking. If you have locked it, it's very good, you have done homework properly. But if you forgot to lock it down, don't worry, it will get locked down itself automatically. Now in round one, the seat is not allotted to you. If the seat, do remember is, the seat will not be allotted here if you don't put a choice. That is very important point. The seat will not be allotted to you at any cost if no choices are filled. Right? So never think that I have not filled the choice, they will automatically give you the seat. They are not going to give you any seat. You have to fill these two things, the choice of the college and the choice of the course. You can forget to lock it, but you have to fill it. If you don't fill, you are not eligible to get a seat in your NEET examination. Very important thing, do remember it. So forgetting about locking is not a problem, it will get automatically locked, but do fill it.
I guess it is always better to lock than...
Yeah, it is always better to lock, but if somehow you forget to lock it, then it is a point.
Better safe than
the
sorry.
Important lock point it. I think that once a student should realize here is that please don't play with the choices. Always try to fill the choices in a way which is your preferred thing. Now you can take the help from the faculties, you can take the help from your seniors. So sometime when you take the help, you know that such and such college is not very good and you want to shift it down. But please remember, whatever is this, because what happens is sometimes student try to put it for the last day and he has not done the exact homework and he has randomly put up the choices. So don't do that. You have put up one college at the top thinking that you will change it in the last hour of the day. Don't just keep it till the last hour, because we have seen these kind of problems that students have faced, that their internet has stopped working or due to some unavoidable problem they did not get the access of the internet or the computer in the last 6 hours. So please make time, please try to get prepared pretty early on this particular case.
Okay. See, on the site can shut down.
Yeah, why no, wait site, if the site will shut down, probably then they will gonna do an arrangement. Why wait? Second important point is, I think Dr. Sushil is gonna explain to you about the allotment. Is there any like mock allotment also before giving the final seat?
No, there won't be anything like that, sir. But in the round one, whatever you have choose, I'll explain to you. The mock allotment will be, if you have forgot or if you have, you know, you have not given any preferred seat, there will be a mock allotment, but then that, you know, that would be.
Yeah, so that is how the MCC guidelines are, that once you will lock your seats, let's say the MCC has given a particular date, let's say 15 a date. Mm-hmm. So on before 15, on the 13, 48 hours before, they will give you a mock allotment that on the basis of your choices, this is the approximate seat that you are getting on the basis of what the students have filled in. You will still will be having a choice to do some shuffling. Manipulations, yeah. So some shuffling, so that like let's say somebody has got Amritsar as an option and he feels that a college that he has put slightly lower down, now he is preferring that particular college over Amritsar. Yes. So then he will be again having a choice to shift it up. So that mock allotment will also be very helpful for you in the round one. So now I think Dr. Sushil will discuss with you that what if you get a seat in the round one and what if you don't get a seat. Okay, so I think let's talk about that.
So in round one, what we said, if you are not filling the choice, you will not get any seat, you are out of the race, finish. So do select the college and the course. Now in round one, two things can happen. Either you will be allotted a seat or you will not be allotted a seat, right? Two things can easily happen. So if the seat is allotted, if seat is allotted to you here, then you have to go to the specific college and you must join the course. So join the college here. It is must. It is mandatory. Even if the choice you have filled, if the subject is not of your choice, you have to go to the college and you have to join the college to be eligible for round two. If you just walk out, if you say I'll not join the college and I'll wait for round two, you are not eligible. Very clear, right? So if the seat is allotted, join the college. If seat is not allotted, what will happen? If no seat allotted to you in round one, then you are automatically eligible for the round two. So here, wait for round two. Right? So two simple things. You have to fill the choice, you have to fill the preference, you have to join the college to be eligible for round two. Else, if you have not got the any seat in round one, then automatically you are eligible for round two, right? But if you leave it that I'll not join, this choice seat is not of my preference, I'm not joining anything, you're out of the race. Very simple. So joining the college is must. Now, when you join the college, it is a confusion how to be eligible for round two. So whenever you will be joining any college which has been allotted to you, you will be getting a form, right? You'll be getting a form here, which you have to fill. A form is to be filled here after joining the college to be eligible for round two, right? A form is to be filled by the student to remain eligible for round two. So this is what you have to do. I hope this is very, very clear. So round one, do fill the college, do fill the choices, then you are eligible for round two. In round two, you get the college, join the college, then fill the form to be eligible for round two. If you are not allotted any seat, any college, you are automatically eligible for round two, right? So these are two things you have to keep in your mind.
I'll slightly interrupt you and ask you a query.
Yeah.
What is the time difference between, I'm talking like a student at present, okay, what is the time difference between round one counseling and round two counseling?
See, last year, if we talk about last year, 2017, 6 days were given for the main counseling, all these form filling and all the registration process. 6 days were given, right? And it was, I guess, between 14th of March and 19th of March, it was given, the time duration. On 20th March, the locking day, it was a locking day, you have to lock down your choices. So for 6 days, you were easily able to shuffle the choices, whatever you want to choose, up and down, you can move the choices. But on 20th was the day when you have to lock it down, right? On 21st and 22nd, the result of allotment was out. That is within 2 days. So total is 6, 7 and 8 days. 8 days time, it was all out. And result was published on 23rd of March. So total duration around 8 or 9 days after round one, the results were published, right? When 12 days were given to report to the allotted college, that means almost 2 weeks, you have ample time to report to your college and join it. After that, after 12 days, means after the 2 weeks, 3 days were again given for the second round counseling. That I'll explain to you.
Okay.
One more point that we will highlight here, friends, like the what Dr. Sushil has said about the round one and round two. So just let me tell you that who all will be eligible for the round two and who all will not be eligible for the round two.
Yeah.
So eligible, if you have allotted a seat in round one, you have joined the college and you have given a form that you want to apply for the second round of counseling. This is first person, first student who will be eligible for the second round.
Yeah.
Second person who has registered, who has filled the choices but has not been allotted a seat.
Yeah.
He will also be eligible automatically for the round two.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about who will not be eligible for the round two. First, who is not registered?
Yeah.
Anybody who has not registered in the first round of counseling will not be eligible for the round two. Please remember, registration is a single time process that can only be done at level one.
Yeah.
Second, person who has been allotted a seat and he has not reported at the allotted institute, he will also not be eligible for the round two. Please remember, friend, it is extremely important. If you have been allotted a seat in a particular institute in round one, you have to report to the institute. If a person has reported and withdrawn or resigned before the round two, then again he will not be eligible for the round two of the counseling. Okay. If he becomes non-eligible due to change in category from unreserved to a reserved category or from reserved to unreserved, because of some reason he has become non-eligible because of the change in the category, again he or she will not be eligible for the round two. Fourth, candidate who have not opted for upgradation. After the round one, the form that you're going to fill at the time of the joining at a particular institute, you will have to fill this as an option whether you want to opt for the round two or not. If you are not opting for the upgradation, you will not be eligible for the round two of the counseling. Please remember, friends, these are non-negotiable terms. So you will have to be very, very careful about this. I am just repeating it. Registration is a one-time process that can only be done at the round one of the counseling before that. Please fill the choices. If you will not fill the choice, you will not be allotted a seat. Okay?
Okay. So this was about round one and how to be eligible for round two, which candidates are eligible and which are not eligible. Now let's say you have gone to round number two. What will happen in round two? Again, two things can happen in round two. So we have entered round two. no seat allotted in round 1 or seat allotted in round 1, but we are interested in appearing in round 2 also. Now in round 2 also, there will be two things. One, seat allotted. So well and good, seat is allotted to you here. So join the college again. Yes, so join the college. That is one. Right? In round 2, you can allot, the seat is allotted, you have to join the college. Now as Dr. Rajat said, there will be a upgradation scheme also. Right? So here, if you have applied already for the upgradation scheme, what will happen? Let's say you have been allotted general surgery here and you want general medicine, right? So you have filled the form that I want to be eligible for upgradation system also. Now it was, it is there, sir. Seat allotted is general surgery and you want to be eligible for upgradation scheme. If in upgradation scheme, it is being told to you that your seat has been upgraded, and now instead of general surgery, you are eligible for general medicine also. But now here you change your mind that I am happy with general surgery. I don't want to take it. So for this, you have to report to your principal of your medical college, right? You have to go to him. You don't have to report anyone in MCC. Go to the principal of your medical college. Tell him I am not interested in upgradation. I am happy with this seat only, right? So this upgraded seat will be allotted to someone else. But this will be done by the principal of your respective medical college, not by MCC. Do remember this, right? So there are two things. Seat allotted, you are happy. Seat allotted, but you wanted to take something else, but at last moment you change your mind. So this will be helped to you by the principal of the respective college, right?
I'll just like to add one point here.
Yeah.
I know round what the students have in mind is ki let's they are fixated on a college or on a field, and most of the students, irrespective of the rank, it does not matter if your rank is 1000, 2000 or 8000. We as humans tend to be dissatisfied with it. So that is why the first step choosing the seats properly during first round, the choice of college and the choice of course is extremely important. I know you can change your mind in the second round, you can change it afterwards or whatsoever, but fix your mind and be slightly flexible. That is what I want to say. Don't go too much into you after round two also, if we are given the option, so let's go to the principal, let's do this, let's do that. Be comfortable with what you have.
So what Sushant has rightly pointed out, friends, please remember MCC does not have an authority on this. It will be done at the level of your dean, director or the principal of the medical college, and there is no clear-cut guideline on this. He may allow this or he may not allow this. So if you are satisfied with the branch that you have got in the rank allowed in the round one, and you are opted for an upgradation, but because once you are upgraded, once you have allotted a seat in round two, that according to MCC, that now that is your seat. Your seat number one is automatically cancelled. So if you are changing your mind, you have filled the option, you are changing your mind between round one to round two, then you have to request the principal or the dean, because ultimately you are not filling this at MCC. You are filling this upgradation at the time when you are giving the joining report at a at that particular college. So why to unnecessarily go into that particular controversy? We are getting one question, so let me just quickly clarify it. If we choose a college in All India Counseling, will we be able to attend state counseling? The answer is yes. There will be a different kind of counseling that will be conducted. I think Dr. Sushil will tell you what are the various, before moving further, what are the various counselings that are available with us. Dr. Sushil? I'm just sharing the list with you in a while. Meanwhile, we can take the FAQs. You can take the other FAQ. But yes, you will be eligible for the state counseling, friends.
We'll explain.
So don't worry about that.
Now, first finish this procedure, and then we'll tell you if you are eligible, not eligible, and how many ways we will have the counseling. Okay. So you have joined the college. This is end of the procedure. That's all. So that is round one, round two. Eligible for round two? Yes or no? If eligible, you have allotted the college. Join it, all end. This is all end, right? You have joined the college, this is finished. Now, after some time, means some time is always given. If we talk of last year, 2017, it was after 9th of May that all the seats which were vacant because of one or other reason, they were shifted to the state quota, right? So, one counseling that we already have is a NEET counseling, the centralized counseling. Second would be your state level counseling. In the meantime, we'll explain to you all the other counselings also. So after some time, whatever duration or the whatever schedule is or will be given to you by MCC will be given in advance, and after that specific time, all the vacant seat, because of one or the other reason, it will be shifted to the state quota. So this is about NEET counselling. I hope this is very much clear to all of you, how you have to appear for the round 1 or the round 2. Only two rounds, there is no confusion about round 3, there is a clear cut guideline by the Supreme Court of India. So there should be only two rounds also, this year also, and that will be the end, round 2. After that, all seats should be shifted to state quota.
Okay, I'll like to ask you one question here, yes, sir. How advisable it is to leave your round 1 seat? I know as a student, they are dissatisfied or they are not that satisfied. They've gotten the branch but not the college.
Okay.
Would you advise them to leave it and, you know, beat ICU and go to round 2, or should,
sir,
they be...
Now, as sir said, the question is very simple. I'm not satisfied with the round 1 seat. I've been allotted MD medicine. I'm not satisfied. I want a general surgery seat. So now there is no, you know, hue and cry about it. It is very, very simple procedure nowadays. You have been allotted a seat in round 1. So you have to go and join it. Very simple. So you are not bothered if you are applying for the round 2. Whenever you go qualify for the round 1, allotted a seat, you will go to the college. You will be filling a form which states that I want to be eligible for round 2. So here you don't have the tension that I lose my primary seat. You are not going to lose it. Until unless you go to the second round and you resign from the primary seat. See, this will be a readmission. You have to do everything in a new manner. You leave a seat in round 1 and you go and join seat in round 2. This will be a new procedure almost. Okay. You have to do everything in a new way. The admission will be a new one. That will be your day 1 of admission. So don't be worried about that I'll lose my primary seat or the secondary seat. Don't be worried about it. But if you get a choice, your seat of your choice in the round 2, it is very much advisable. Go for that. There is no need to panic that I lose my this seat or that seat. This is a very simple and safe game now. You have to just understand how I have to follow the procedure. If you follow it, there is no harm in changing the seat in round 2 also.
Okay. Now, so, any FAQ? Yeah. So, what are the documents that will be required once you will be applying? The exact list of the documents, Dr. Sushil, can you share with us?
So the list of documents that you need at the time of your, you know, enrollment with the college, particular college, they are the admit card. Should I write it down? So you can note it down if you want. So number 1 will be your admit card that was on your mail given by NB. Number 2 would be the result letter, the rank letter that you say, the result or the rank letter. Number 3 will be the mark sheets of all the years, 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th, the mark sheets. Number 4 would be the internship completion certificate, ICC, right? And if it is not yet completed, then you have to give it, like, it will be finished by 31st of March. So obviously we are hoping counseling will happen after that also only. Then you will have to submit a provisional or permanent registration certificate. This is registration certificate. Then provisional or permanent your MBBS degree, and for birth certificate for your class 10th or the 12th mark sheet, you have to produce it. One ID proof is must. Now these are 8 documents. Document number 9, you have to take care about it. What is that? You have to carry the certificate of your, you know, caste certificate. Now, what is so important about this caste certificate? It is clearly mentioned in the literature of last year that we have. This year's literature is not yet published, so we are keeping everything like last year. That should be either in Hindi or in English. Regional language certificate will not be allowed and it will not be given a preference, right? So this certificate that you have, the caste certificate, should be in Hindi or in English. That you have to keep in mind. If it is not available with you, get it done either Hindi or in English. Number 1 thing. Number 2, whosoever is presenting a physically handicapped certificate, institutes have been recognized, and only the certificates which are issued by these institute will be catered. The institute for the locomotor disabled candidates, they have to get themselves certified from one of these institute. 4 institute have been identified for physically handicapped certificate. These are, number 1 is the Vardhaman Mahavir Medical College, that is Safdarjung Hospital, New Delhi. Okay, number 2 will be from Mumbai, that is All India Institute of Physical Medicine. This is All India Institute of Physical Medicine. That is in Mahalakshmi area, Mumbai. This is in Mumbai. Number two. Number three institute is in Kolkata. This is Institute of Postgraduation. This is Institute of Postgraduate Medical Education. This is in Kolkata, and number four institute is the Madras Medical College. These are four institutes. From here you have to make a certificate. This is in Chennai. Madras Medical College is in Chennai. So these are the four areas from where you have to get your physically handicapped certificate. So your caste certificate should either be in Hindi or in English, and the physically handicapped certificate, this has to be signed or made by one of these institutes. Okay, so do remember them. These are the documents that you need to carry at the time of your registration with the college, whatever has been allotted to you.
I'll interrupt you at this point, sir, and I'm again asking like a student.
Yeah.
How much time, like there are four metropolitan cities, I guess, Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai.
Yeah.
So I guess the students who are eligible for this category, yeah, should work on this ASAP. In the sense that they should not wait till then. And how much time does it take to get these certificates made for the eligible students?
Sir, see, time nobody can tell.
Think most of the time they have it.
They already have they it. Have
most
it.
Of the time they have it.
Okay.
So in case if you don't have the certificate right now, so still the time is there. Counseling has yet not started, so you can get it done. So in what we have seen is 12 days will be the time given to you for joining a particular college. So just to, you know, avoid the last minute rush, you should get it done as soon as possible. So if you are having the certificate, well and good. If you are not having, you already know your ranks and you know that you have to get an admission under this particular category. So get it done as early as possible. Why to wait for the counseling date?
I think because of the technical glitch, there are some points that have been missed. So just for the 2 minutes, can you quickly elaborate what you said in the last 2 minutes?
Okay, so what we have discussed in last 2 minutes are the documents which are required while you go to join a college. These are the documents that you can see on the screen. These are required to join a particular college. That is, one is your admit card, which is already available on your emails. Result that you have just got now. Mark sheet of all the MBBS years. Internship completion certificate. Provisional or permanent certificate of your registrations, MBBS degree, 10th and 12th certificate for your date of birth, one ID proof is must, and then is the caste certificate, right? Caste certificate should either be in Hindi or in English, okay? Then is the physically handicapped certificate. Now, what is important about this PH certificate is that four institutes have been identified. These are Vardhaman Mahavir Medical College, New Delhi. Second is All India Institute of Physical Medicine, Mumbai. Institute of Postgraduate Medical Education, Kolkata, and Madras Medical College from Chennai. These four institutes, you must have a certificate issued by one of these institutes, right? So just to avoid the last minute rush, you can get it done right now because you already know your rank and you know which seat you are going to get, right? You already know all the things. Okay, so these are the documents required for your registration with the college for a permanent seat.
Okay. Any other FAQ in the procedure that we need to discuss? So all this list will be shared. We are getting a lot of queries on the list, so we will be sharing this list on our premier page, so that if a student is not able to write it down, so you can just see that list on our premier page. Okay.
So penalty.
And one more thing is about that 31st March date that you mentioned, Dr. Sushil. So can you just tell to our students that if somebody is not finishing the internship on 31st March? So if a student is not finishing the internship on 31st March, then he is not eligible to take a seat in this particular counseling. Please remember, that has been very, very clearly written that as per the All India NEET PG, your internship should be finished by 31st March 2018. If you are finishing it before that date, only then you can pick up a seat. Again, it is non-negotiable clause. You cannot do anything on this. If the counseling is happening before that and the internship completion certificate is not available, you need to take it from your own college that an undertaking by the head of the institute or by the principal that you will be finishing your internship by 31st of March.
And okay. I guess that's very easily available.
That will be very easily available.
Absolutely not an issue at all.
One very important thing that even I missed and has been asked on our DRP is that when you fill the choices for round 1 and you are allotted a seat or not allotted a seat, you are automatically eligible for round 2. What about round 2? How that will start? So round 2 will again start like round 1 only. You again have to fill the choices. You will be given some duration for 3 days or the 6 days as will be described on the website by your MCC. So you will be again given some time and in that meantime you again have to fill the choices. Right? Again like round 1, the college's preference and the seat preference, that whatever is left will be visible to you on the website. Okay. And
I'll take up a question, a very very interested question that has been asked by one of the students, that I have been allotted a seat in round 1 and after joining I opt for upgradation. Is there a chance that I might lose my allotted seat and get downgraded to a less preferred seat? No. There is a very very clear cut guideline on this. This is called as an upgradation. And if there is a lot of, I have read in detail on this particular part, that if you have opted for the round 2 of the allotment and a choice which is more preferred than the previous choice is not available, then your seat is secured with you. It is called as an upgradation. If you have been allotted a seat at rank preferred number 10th in your list and anything in the first 9 is not available, then your seat is retained with you. Okay, but please remember, if you are upgraded, if you are upgraded, you will have to join and your that seat will automatically be cancelled. The first seat. Yeah. And that is sometime what happens is that between the round 1 and round 2 there will be a gap of approximately 3 weeks or 4 weeks MCC has to say. In that period, if you change your mind that no, I don't want an upgradation, I just want to remain with that particular seat, MCC does not have a say in that, and that should be done at their college level. So I will suggest to all students, please, if you are feeling it, please be it with the mind that whatever thing that you are putting ahead of the seat that has been allotted to you, that should be a more preferred seat. Please don't offer a less preferred seat at a higher list, then that will be a big problem for you.
I'll just like to add one point here. When we talk about upgradation is a very relative term. What is an upgradation for me might be downgradation for somebody else. So choosing your seats, so writing down your rank list and your preferred seat list, that this is what I want to do in life, is extremely important. Just a small example, suppose somebody wants to upgrade from surgery to medicine. It might be an upgradation for him, but for somebody else, surgery might be the preferred seat. So decide what you want, and upgradation is a relative term. That's what I want.
So Dr. Sushil will once again explain about the caste certificate. I think we have got enough messages on that. I will request students, just write message once. And if you will write it once, we are having this and we will take care of that. So don't worry about this. Otherwise, it will be difficult for us to see the other DRP queries and the doubt of the other student might be missed. Okay.
So there is a message from Varangal that please explain about the caste certificate once again. See, the caste certificate, I guess most of the students already have the caste certificate before you have entered your MBBS college. If because of some reason, if you don't have it, please get it in the mean course of time. Number one. Number two, this should be in English or Hindi language. If you are having your caste certificate in your regional language, please get it changed to either Hindi or English one, because these are the only two which will be accepted during the counseling process.
And I think in some states it is, I don't know why, it should not be there, but it is written in FAQs that only the English one will be accepted.
Yeah, in
so
some
if
states.
It is your language, it's in your regional language, it is always better to get it
In English.
In English.
Yeah, so get it in English or Hindi. Hindi, most of the areas may not be knowing Hindi, so better is to get your caste certificate in English language only. Right? That is about caste certificate, I guess. So I guess there is some technical glitch from Warangal area. There we are continuously getting the message about the caste certificate. So there is some technical problem, please correct it, because we'll be losing all the other messages from other students.
Other messages have been like lost now.
Okay.
But anyways, so now moving on to this. So there is round 1 and round 2. Now friends, please remember, so how the process will be, again the guidelines have not yet come, but what happens is usually between the round 1 and round 2 there will be a gap of 3 to 4 weeks, and in that time many more counselings will happen. So what we will be doing is, now we will tell you what are the number of seats that are available and what are the counseling options that a student has. Okay, so Dr. Sushil, can we get that list in which we have got the number of seats and the counseling?
Yeah, this is the list, sir.
Yeah. So now if you look at this,
okay, so if we talk about the total number of seats, because we have lost almost all the other messages because of one single message, just one more query from Kochi. If we stop with the first round, if we are satisfied, will we be proceeded automatically to round 2? So the answer is no. If you have opted for a seat in round 1 and you are going to the college and you have joined the course, there will be a form that you need to fill to be eligible for round 2. So don't fill that form. If you are satisfied with round 1, go to the college and join it. Automatically, you are allotted a college and a seat. So you are not going to round 2 then. Okay. Second query is from Nerul. Do we have to fill the preference form again after round 1? Yes. After round 1, either your seat is allotted or not allotted. In both the cases, if you are eligible for round 2, process will be again same as I explained earlier. You have to fill the choices again. You have to fill the colleges and the preferred course again. Okay. So, okay, this is, these are the two questions that we have. Rest all the questions we have lost already from DRP.
You can put the question again.
Jhansi.
If any question has been missed related to the procedure of the counseling.
Yeah.
Let's not jump onto the questions. Let's stay with the way that we are going. Otherwise, it will be difficult to manage the things.
Yeah.
So, let's focus on the procedure. And right now, we have only talked about the NEET All India Counseling for the 50% of the seats.
Yeah.
One of the common questions that we are getting from the student on this is that whether the Telangana and the AP states will be included in this, as it was not there till the last year. So friends, please remember, so they all go with the NEET. If you look at the NEET UG and the NEET Super Speciality, the 50% of the All India seats of the AP and the Telangana were included in that. So same is this process here also, that these seats will be included in the All India 50% quota this year. But in that case the students of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh will also be eligible for the All India. So the net difference will be negligible. So there will not be much difference. So there will be around 600 to 700 candidates who will be in the first 5000 to 6000, and there will be almost that much seats that will be added to the list. So the net result will be more or less same. So it will not affect the
overall status.
So Dr. Sushil will tell us the number of seats that
see
we have
these
now.
Questions that Dr. Rajat said, we'll be taking everything step by step.
Yeah.
So we have multiple questions. What about DNB? What about state council? We'll take up everything in a sequence. Let's not make it hodgepodge, you know.
Yeah.
So first thing, total seats, how many are available? So what query you can put over here right now is anything in the procedure to be eligible for the counseling. How you have to appear for the counseling, right? If you have any query, put it here and then we'll go step by step. Total seats for MD, MS and Diploma right now, approximately around 28,000. These are approximate seats. 28,700 is the approximate number of seats that we have. Right? Everything is based on last year's data. So these are approximate number of seats. Approximately 28,700 MD, MS and total Diploma seats. If we take out the four institutes, that is your AIIMS, your PGI, JIPMER and NIMHANS. These four, if we just take them out, so total number of seats these institute make, that is around 750 approximately. So something around 730 to 740 seats these institute give to the country, right? So out of these, total what is left is 27,000 something, around 900 or maybe
28,000,
maybe around 28,000 or so. So these are the seats for which we are fighting actually.
And this includes government and private both.
Yeah, so this includes all the government as well as the private medical colleges.
So I guess we can share the government 18K.
Yeah, I'll just tell you. So it is all about the government plus private medical colleges, right, which are included or not included in NEET, right? So this includes everything. Now out of this, how much is available under the NEET 50% quota that we are talking about, the counseling process, is approximately 87, no?
So this 28,000 are the total number of seats excluding the AIIMS, PGI, JIPMER and NIMHANS.
Yeah.
Now let's divide them into government and private. So we are just taking a quick break of 2 minutes and after that all these technical issues will be sorted out and then we'll again take it forward. Okay, so just 2 minutes and then we'll be right back.
Thank you.